coming at you from Louisville, Kentucky, as a matter of fact. I don't know, I think maybe some folks might wonder what I do out here on the road. I drive a Peterbilt truck here, but I pull a pneumatic trailer, and you know, some folks have asked me exactly what that is, and I'm going to show you here. A pneumatic trailer is basically just a big sealed tank, and it's got four hoppers in it. We'll show you them in a bit, and we haul food with it, though these units can haul anything that is considered a flowable solid, like we haul sugar, maltodextrin, cornstarch, flour, anything like that that's technically a solid, but it's just very small particulate, and basically it can be blown, and that's what we do. I'll show you here. This truck. Connected to the truck motor by a power takeoff or PTO. You engage that inside the truck, and then that powers up the blower. And then that hose right there puts the air into the tank. And the tank gets filled with air at a particular pressure, and I'll show you that in a minute. And then you can see it back there is the hose going into the plant. And then that big tower is just a big tank where the sugar in this case is held. And at this plant, I guess they can make cake mixes and frostings and shit like that. When we unload this stuff, it can take anywhere between an hour and a half to 2 hours, maybe a little more. It just depends on how high a pressure they allow us to pressure their system. With sugar, it's anywhere between 10 pounds, or usually around 10 pounds, sometimes 8, sometimes even lower. Just depends on how many filters you have to go through inside of their system. But today, it's my lucky day, because I can run it anywhere between 14 and 15 pounds, which is pretty, pretty high pressure. Now, these particular units, I could be pulling sand. Like when I was working out in the oil fields, there was a lot of these trucks hauling sand, frack sand, to push down the oil wells, or the oil wells being drilled. But then also, concrete powder, silica, anything like that, anything that is, again, particulate and small and can be blown. Basically, the air just stirs up in there and it blows out the hole. Okay. This here is the whole rig, and on the dash, we'll do is engage the clutch there. And then up on the dash is the button up there that engages the PTO. And then we take the cruise. You can't see it. The cruise button up on the dash. And idle it up to about 1,000 RPMs, between 900 and 1,000. And that engages the PTO, which is down in there. And then pumps the air up through here. And then the air goes into, this is called the product line, once you get past this valve. And each one of these is a hopper. Each one of these V's here is a bottom. Basically, it's all one tank. But the product is heaped up, kind of like this, and then down, and then it's loaded at the plant up top in those hatches. And then each of these hatches, and every point where it could be accessed. You see down there is a seal. They're numbered. So every time we load or unload, we have to make sure that each one of these, the top, all of our hoses, everything is all sealed, because it's food grade. You want to make sure nobody's tampering with it. So anyway, when we start up, we'll come back, and back here we have an air valve. It's called the top air valve. Right now I have it just cracked, and we'll open that up and make sure this is closed. This is the bleeder valve. This is the valve. When we're done, we just open it wide open and let all the pressure out. Then we come back here and we'll shut this valve, and that takes pressure out of the product line, because the product, in this case sugar, falls out and then will be blown all the way back to that hose going in there. But when we pressure it up, close that, and then the air is diverted from there into this line here, and then that goes all the way around back there and comes here. And you can open these valves. Those are called vibrators, because those operate that line, and there's a special valve in there that actually vibrates the product. Or it goes around back to that valve I showed you before, back here, to what we call top air, and then it goes up this pipe, and then it pressures down on the product. So right now, I am unloading, and my pressures are running just right around 14 and a half. I think I'm going to open this up a little bit and get it up there. Faster the better. Get it up over 14. And then I'm going to check my product, see where I'm at here. See, that's empty. As we come down, it's getting empty here. Hear that? Come down over here. I've already emptied this pod here. Hear that? Okay. That's how you kind of use your ears to feel or to hear what's going on. And then we also listen to the motor, the sound of the motor that tells us what's going on as well. So pressure is staying right at about a little under 14. I'm going to open this one up. Start climbing up, and then I'll just adjust it from there. We can also adjust the pressure inside the tank by cracking this open a little bit if we want to bring it down. And I'll take you around back here. And this is where it comes out. That's where that product line comes out, the back of the trailer here. And then, as you can see the product. You can see through the hose. You can see the product flowing through the hose. And then, come in here where it's hooked up into their system. It goes way up there. And this is the bottom of their giant sugar hopper tank here. And then it goes, you know, into the plant where they make whatever. Not my concern. But just wanted to show you what it is I do out here. Why they pay me the big money, I guess. All right, see, my pressure is coming back up a little bit over 14 there. And that's where I want it, 14 to 15. The higher the pressure, the faster I get out of here. again, most places only let you run around 10, but here we don't have any